Today we will continue with our discussion on types of dredging. And just to revise, we had seen in the last lecture the first type, or we have started with the grab or clamshell dredging, the first one. It is nothing but you have a bucket type of arrangement, grab bucket, and then it is lowered into the water, and then at the base of the waterbed or at the waterbed, it is just opened and closed so that whatever is the material you want to excavate, that gets collected into it. Okay, so these are the typical pictures of that grab shell, clamshell or grab dredging. Okay. Then we discuss the general points and advantages also related to it. Then the next type, second type we saw, that is ladder or bucket dredging. In this, what we have is we have a series of buckets which are installed over a sort of conveyor belt assembly or a ladder also you can say, and then it is lowered such a way, and it is lowered and it is moved in such a way, okay, or it is rotated about the two tumblers you can see here, or the ladder pivot. It is moved about the tumbler, top tumbler and bottom tumbler, and it is moved in such a way that in the process of movement it scraps the bed and then it collects the material. And the movement of the ladder, the up and down movement of this ladder, it is possible because there is a ladder pivot which is provided here. So your up and down movement, it will be about this pivot point. So this is the ladder or bucket dredging. And we had seen in the comparison, if you do, between grab dredging and ladder dredging. So ladder dredging, it is mainly useful for loose soils because we really don't have any cutting head or instrument which will cut the hard or stiff soil. Contrary to that, in the grab dredging, at least we had the we can attach some teeth type of assembly to the bucket edges so that it is sort of a cutting edge. So these were the two types that we see that we had seen in the last lecture. So today we'll continue with the next type. So third type in the mechanical type of dredging, that is the open dredging, or also known as excavated dredging. Now from the name itself you can guess, or from the photo it's very clear what we have in this is we have a barge or a dredge type of structure, okay, which is this one, the floating structure, and over that you have a excavator. Excavator is nothing but a construction equipment which is capable of having an attachment at this end, and that attachment can be a bucket or it can be a drill bit, okay? And then you are able to excavate the material, whether it is a hard rock or whether it is soft soil or a stiff soil, you can excavate it. So that's the excavator dredging or open dredging. So if I in this picture also you will see now, so here you see it is just removing, or this excavator is having a bucket which is attached to this end, and that bucket is just scrapped, or it is removing the solids, or in this case it is a lake and it is removing the sedimentation and the weeds and whatever is the unnecessary material. And it is not really, or the machine, it is not really into the water, but it is somewhere on the land, as you can see here, and just due to this arm it is able to excavate in the water. So you many of a time this type of dredging or excavator or open dredging, it is also called as amphibious dredging. Amphibious because it can be used, or this excavator, it can be used on land also. While the excavator is on land, you can dredge from the water body, or it can be used directly in the water also, as you can see here. So again, you have a large barge over here, and then you have this excavator which is placed at one end of that barge, and then it excavates the area over here. And the bucket is nothing but the whatever you are, most of you know it by the, or it is in common or layman's term, it is known as JCB. So actually that's not a JCB, that's an excavator. So whatever bucket you have seen to that excavator, the same bucket is used here. Okay. So the points to be noted is The excavators that you use are backhoe or shovel. So that bucket, what I'm talking about, it is also known as shovel, or you have a backhoe. Backhoe is nothing but when at the opposite end or back end, the rear end of the excavator, you have an attachment. That's a backhoe. And as you can guess, that whatever will be the length of this arm of that excavator, only that much will be the capability of your bucket going deep into the water. So you have a restriction on the depth over there. So it is useful if you have a low depth excavation. So in initial lectures of this dredging, I told you that the Ganesh Salav that we have, or Ganesh Lake that we have near our college. So over there, for the past 1 month, there was this dredging activity which was going on, in which they were removing all the unnecessary weeds and grasses and the sedimented material from the lake. So that method or that dredging was nothing but excavator or open dredging, in which they had an excavator brought into the lake, and that excavator was partially into the water and partially on the land, and then it excavated all the unnecessary material. So again, that lake is not too deep also, so this low depth excavation is possible with this excavator or open dredging type of technique. And then again, you have a limitation on the volume, because whatever is this volume of bucket, that much only material you can excavate in one drag. So grab bucket, we have seen it has volumes which are varying from 1 meter cube to 20 meter cube. Yeah, this was the case for the grab bucket. But now in this case, the excavator buckets that we have, they are not of this high capacity. They are very less, even less than 1 meter cube. Okay. So that's why you can excavate only a limited material at a certain point of time or during one drag. And one of the obvious disadvantages of this method is this, that it creates more suspended particle. Now, if you consider these two buckets, we have seen one type of bucket in the first method, that is grab bucket. So that grab bucket was, it was something like this. Okay, that this bucket was capable of opening in both the directions or in one direction. Okay, so it was sort of a closed bucket. The only end that was open is the top end, from which the excess water would come out. So this was our grab bucket. And in excavator bucket, what we have is, we simply have one sort of like this open bucket you have. And it may have some teeth. So the shape doesn't matter. What I'm trying to show is this complete end, this is open. As compared to the grab bucket, in which the bucket was closed, both the sides of the bucket, they would come together and it would create a closed bucket. So if you say that in grab dredging also suspended particles are more, so that's not completely true. In grab dredging, there is suspended particles which are created, but the amount is less as compared to this open dredging or excavator dredging. The reason is this one end is open, so by the time you scrap the base of your water body or bed of your water body, and then you bring it up, so in that process, whatever is the soil or excavated material which is on the top side or open side, that will tend to flow away with the water, causing a lot of suspended particles. So again, while dredging, you can't have really an estimation that how deep we have dredged the bed. Okay, so every time you have to wait for some time to let the suspended particle settle down, and then you can have a clear picture that what is this scenario below water. Okay. So that's a disadvantage of your open or excavated dredging. And this is some more photos of it. These structures that you see, this black tower-like things, so these are for lifting purposes. So you can have wires and ropes or pulley assemblies or even motors connected, and then whatever are the heavy machinery in this area, so you can lift it. So for that purpose, this towers are provided. Okay, so this, you can call them towers. Okay, and you can install any machinery on it which is capable of lifting your equipment. So these are the towers. This is another example, and yeah, you can see the bucket over here now clearly. Okay, so I was telling you it's open at one end, and it's the same bucket that you have seen for any road construction or any digging work or excavation work which is going on in your city or nearby area. So it's the same type of bucket, even the same excavator. The only difference is they have taken that excavator, placed it on a barge, and that barge is somewhere in middle of the water. Okay. So this is about the excavator and or open dredging, or also known as amphibious dredging. The next type of dredging is cutter head dredging. Now we have switched on to the classification. Till now we were discussing the mechanical types of dredging. Now we have switched to the hydraulic one. Okay. In mechanical, we saw grab or clamshell, ladder or bucket, and excavator or open type of dredging. Now the next we are going to see now is the cutter head. So it's hydraulic, or it is known as, or it comes under the category of hydraulic dredging, because it involves the process of excavation or the process of extraction. It involves a lot of water, use of water. Okay, or even the movement of your ladders and everything. It can be either by the ropes or it can be hydraulically operated, but that hydraulic is different. Hydraulic oil is different, and the category under which this comes, the hydraulic category, that hydraulic means there is involvement of water component either in the excavation part, or it is involved in the extraction part, or it is involved in the disposal part. So in any of the three phases or three stages of your treatment or dredging works, you have water involved. So that's why it comes under the hydraulic category. Now from simply from the photos, if you try to make out what is the exact cutter head dredging, so it's looks something like this. So in photo number one and photo number two, you can see the cutter head dredgers. So in photo number one, you can see the complete dredger. It's a small one, a very small size cutter head dredging, in which you have this cutter head. The main name which it derives is from the cutting head that is attached to one end. Okay. And then if you concentrate on this figure, on this front part, so that you can see two types of pipes. One is the red pipe, which is having a larger diameter, and another is a blue pipe, this one, which is having a smaller diameter. So this red pipe is the one to which the actual cutter is attached, and this cutter can rotate. So, and you can see some projections here. So these are nothing but the teeth of your cutter. Okay, so pointed teeth are there, or you can say it is sort of a drill bit. Okay, so these are the teeth of your cutter, and then they rotate, and then they cut the material, and simultaneously at the same time, this blue pipe, it is a suction pipe which will suck all the excavated material. So that with that excavated material, water also comes into picture. Okay, so that's why it is under the hydraulic category. So I told you that hydraulic category dredging, in that either the excavation part has water involved in it, or the extraction part, or the disposal part. So in cutter head, the extraction part, after excavating the material, whatever the extraction process, so that involves water in it. So that's why it's a hydraulic type of dredging. And figure number or photo number two, you can see the cutter head with a closer view. So you can see now these are sort of a small scrapers. So depending on what is the type of soil or type of bed you have underneath the water, that will decide what type of teeth or what type of cutter head you will use. So either you can have such scraper type of teeth, or you can have such In photo number one, whatever teeth you see, those are sharp ones. So that's because there might be a hard surface below the water over here in photo, case of photo number one. So just to go into the detail that what, how actually this cutter head dredging works, because why I am going to discuss this a bit more in detail, because in most of the navigation channels, where you have to prepare new channels or you have to even maintain the channels, maintain the depth, so this cutter head dredging is used. So it is widely used all over the world. So that's why I'll go a bit detail into it. So this is the animated picture of a cutter head dredger or cutter head dredging. If you see at the components, at one end, I told you that there is a cutter head which will actually excavate the material. Okay, so this is the cutter head at the end. Now this cutter head is able to, it's not like it's always into the water. We have seen in this photo, in photo number one, that cutter head is above, well above the water level. Okay, so obviously that cutter head is able to move up and down. So that up and down movement of this cutter head is because it is attached to a ladder, and this ladder, then you can lift it or you can place it downwards. Now from this figure you can see that lifting of the ladder will be possible with this pulley and rope assembly. Okay, or you can have also have mechanized winches for it. You have already seen what is a winch in your grab dredging or clamshell dredging. So this ladder movement, it is done by this, with the help of this rope pulley or a winches assembly. Now I told you after excavation or during excavation itself, simultaneously you have to take out the excavated material. So for that you have this pipe, which is the suction pipe. Now you can see some brown color in it. So that brown color is because it is showing that there is excavated material inside it. So that's why it's shown in brown color. Okay. Now obviously, if I'm saying that it's a suction pipe, so there should be some kind of a motor or a device which will suck the excavated material. So for that, this is the motor that you have shown in the orange color. So you can see directly that motor is connected to the suction pipe, and as the cutter head moves, as it excavates, the suction pipe also continuously, it goes on sucking out the excavated material along with a lot of water. And then if you follow the path of this pipe, suction pipe, so you can see it is being taken out through pipe itself. So whatever is the excavated or the dredged material, it is taken through pipes, and then through pipes it is either dumped into the nearby location where you have to reclaim the land, or it is dumped in the barges if the reclamation point is far away, or it is directly taken over the land surface and it is disposed of. So either ways it can be done, and as it is involving the excavated material, is involving a lot of water in it, so that's why it is preferred to be transferred through pipes. Because if you just openly transport it or openly dump it, maybe the water, in a lot of water in it, will cause a lot of trouble. So it's good to take it away with the help of the pipe network. And then this all components, they are placed over the barge. Obviously you need some floating platform, and that floating floating platform is provided by this barge. So this completely is a barge. This complete thing what you see here, this is a barge. And then obviously to drive that barge you need some engine. So this is the engine beyond this pipe, whatever area you see over here. So it's the engine of that barge. Then you see few more components over here, that is these components. Now these are nothing but the anchors. Okay, now you all know what is an anchor in a ship. Anchor is nothing but, if you have to park your ship, okay, in terms of ships, it is called mooring. Okay, we'll see that in the next unit, or unit number 5, but for now It is called mooring, MOORING. So mooring is nothing but actually parking itself, but for cars or vehicles, road vehicles, we say the term parking, but for ships we say mooring. Okay. So anyways, the point is, you all know what is an anchor. It looks something like this. The traditional anchor, if you see, it is a heavy metal kind of thing, something like this. And it can be dropped into the water body, and then due to its weight, it goes and stays at the bed, and due to which it stabilizes the ship. Now, the anchors in this cutter head dredging, they are a bit different. Okay, these anchors are also used, but they are used at a different location. I'll come to that shortly. But what you see, the main anchors over here, so these are a pipe-like or a heavy tube-like structure. They can be hollow or they can be a solid. Generally, they are solid because you want them to be heavy and stable so that they can go inside. And what you can see on the right side, if you see the animation part, so the orange ones are the anchors and they are embedded into the bed of your water body. But unlike the traditional anchors, what happens is when you drop an anchor or when you use an anchor, the ship, it stays at that particular position. So in this case, we want our dredger to be at a particular location, but we want it to move sideways. So these anchors, they keep the dredger stable at one point, but they also allow the dredger to move sideways. Okay, so if I have to move the dredger to the left side or to the right side, so that can be done with the anchors intact itself in the ocean bed. So one end or the rear end of this dredger, it will be fixed, and the front end, which is carrying the ladder and the cutter head, that end can move freely left or right. Okay, so your anchors are specially designed in that way in case of a cutter head dredging. And then I have said that you can move your dredger left or right. Now this left or right movement, it is done by the engine, and also this cutter head or this ladder, you can move it left or right by this help of the side wire winches. Okay, now again, here is the picture that you have seen before also. What is a winch? So it is a heavy rope which is wound onto a roller, and it is electrically operated. So those winches, they are attached over here. You see in the front. Yeah, over here you can see. So these are the winches, and they are fixed over here. And the free end of the winch, free end is this hook, what you can see over here in the left, top left figure. This hook, what you see, so that is the free end of that winch. So those free ends, or you can see the rope coming out of this winch. I am just darkening it with the red color. Then you have a sort of again orange component over here, which changes the direction of the rope. Okay. So you have to turn that rope 90 degrees. So that's why you have a pulley kind of thing over here. And then this free end, you can see something here. So this is the conventional anchor that you have. So the anchor that we had seen, which is of this shape, if I just draw a line diagram. So this conventional anchor that we have, so to that anchor, the hook is attached. Okay. And once you drop the anchor, so the hook will remain as it is. And same is done on the other side also. So you can see this winch number two, it is having this rope. Again, you have a pulley, and then the direction is changing of this rope. And then the free end of the winch, it is connected to this anchor over here. Over here, you can see the shape, sort of the triangular one. Now what will happen is, once you drop this anchor, then this winches will just pull, create a tension to move the cutter head in either of the directions. So if I pull this rope, So your movement will be in one direction, and if I pull the other rope, the movement will be in the other direction. So using this winches on both the ends of the cutter head, you move the cutter head actually left or right. Okay. So that's the purpose of this side wire winches. Okay. Actually, I have shown the arrow here, but that is only one end of the winch, and this is actually the anchor. So even if I have put the arrow over here, that is side wire winches, these are actually the side wire winches, one end, and this over here is the another end of that winch. Okay, so that is where the arrow goes. And then, as I told you, the side wire winches, they are used to move the cutter heads sideways. In this figure also, you can see the blurred portion, this one. It is the original or previous position of the dredger, and then I am pulling or I am creating tension in this side of the rope. So my cutter head, it is moving to the right side. And if you see this dark blue color path, so this is showing how much is the dredged portion. So previously, you see the dredged portion was this, or the edge was this dredging edge. Now the dredging edge has gone forward. So in this way, while dredging itself, you can move the dredger ahead, and then you can go on dredging the bed. And I told you the free end of the winch, it is attached to side anchor. So these are the side anchors, what you see over here. And then these anchors, now once you drop an anchor, you do your work, you move your cutter head left or right. Now, once it has done all the excavation in this area, suppose, now you have to go ahead. So, in that case, you have to also move these anchors ahead. So, this movement of these anchors, it can be done either within the dredger itself. So, you can have a boom. Boom is nothing but a short crane-like thing. Okay. So, this is the boom. Now, this boom is used to move the anchors ahead or backwards or sideways wherever you want. Or if you don't have a boom on your dredger, so there are small work boats which are there around your dredger. So those work boats will lift the anchor and then they will take it to the next position. Okay. So instead of work boat, we prefer this boom kind of assembly on the dredger itself. Okay. So that your anchors can be controlled by the person who is in charge of this barge itself. So again, this is a typical actual photograph of that one of the cutter head dredgers. So again, you see this is the cutter head. You can see a white pipe over here at the bottom, that is the suction pipe. And then this is the rest of the barge and the dredger. So already I have explained what are the components. So cutter head is important component, then suction pipe, ladder, motor, engine, and barge. And this method, as I told you, it is widely used because it is very good for maintenance of the navigation channels. Now, as in India, we don't have a lot of inland water network, waterways, but in abroad countries, lot of countries use their inland waterways, the rivers and the canals, for navigation purpose. So there regularly they have to be dredged so that the depth is maintained. So for that purpose, this cutter head dredging can be used, and it is applicable for all types of bed conditions. So either it can be a rock or soil also. So you have seen, if it's a soil, you can use a scraper type of teeth to your cutter head, or if it is a hard rock, then you can have a pointed drill bit kind of a teeth to your cutter head. And the only disadvantage of this method is that it's a bit costly, because if you see, as compared to your bucket or even the grab dredging, so grab dredging mein kya tha? You had only ropes, pulleys, winches, and a grab bucket. Okay. That was everything in all the three mechanical types also. But in here, what you have is you have introduced a motor which will suck the excavated material, you have that suction pipe, you have the network of pipe that you have laid to take out the dredge material, so that increases the cost. Also, you have that whole ladder and cutter head thing that you that requires more power. So there, the overall cost of your dredging increases. Now, there is, as I told you, there are a lot of videos related to dredging that you'll find on YouTube. One specially, I found a documentary, short documentary of a couple of minutes. If you have heard of this canal, Suez Canal. So Suez Canal is nothing but it is the canal which is in between Egypt and the rest of the Asia. So it's sort of a water body which joins, or you can say also separates, the Egypt. Egypt is in Africa. So Egypt and Asia ke beech mein you have this Suez Canal. So there was a project in which the existing Suez Canal, they created another branch of that Suez Canal. In between there was obviously land, okay, and they just created another branch. So this they created in 10 months, and a lot of different types of dredgers were used. So one of that dredger used was cutter head dredger, okay, in the locations where you had sand or soft silty material. So there this cutter head dredger was used. So that's all with this type. We'll stop here for today. In the next lecture, we'll continue with the next two types, that is the horizontal auger and the suction. So this two will continue